next guest is a comic shining the spotlight on some of our less desirable traits.
Australians overseas, I don't know if we're ready to be overseas. Like, we don't belong overseas. Ever met an Australian overseas? You'd just be somewhere overseas, just enjoying the sights and sounds, and suddenly you hear an Australian, oh, yeena, yeena! Conversations I always have overseas, oh, Nazeem, I just love being overseas, you know, just immersing myself in the local culture. Just love immersing myself in the local culture, you know. Mate, you are in Phuket in an Irish pub. There's no culture here.
Thank goodness we're cultured, though. Would you please welcome Nazeem Hussain? Yeah.
What is going on, you stupid white puppets?
I was a dare.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, was it? Really?
Yeah, no, it was, yeah, your producer said I dare to say that and get
oh,
us cancelled.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm offended, man.
You're offended? Yeah. Oh, yeah. What about Waleed? Are you offended?
Well, I should probably be, yeah.
More so. But hang on, Naz, in that clip, though, aren't all tourists just super annoying? Like, is it really us that's...
I don't know, but, like, you know, when you hear foreign accents overseas, like, they sound like... to us, foreign and exotic, but when you hear an Australian overseas, it's just something piercing about it. Like, yeena, yeena. Well, you sound like birds that really should be, like, kind of like bin chickens overseas. Like, I was in KL with my sister. We're in a 7-Eleven, and this Aussie guy just barges in, grabs a Cornetto out of the fridge and pushes in front and just starts asking the guy serving it. He goes, like, do you know where the massage parlours are, mate? Do you know where I can find the massage parlours? The guy didn't understand what he was saying. So in the Australian dude's mind, he thought, well, if he doesn't bloody understand me, I'll just keep repeating myself louder and louder in more of an Aussie accent until he gets it. Massage parlour! Massage parlour! Till he gets so fed up, he turns to me and my sister and goes, mate, no one can bloody speak English around here. Am I right, mate? And then just walks off. To this day, I have no idea why he turned to me and my little sister, two brown people, presumably also not English-speaking people in a foreign country. But anyway, we need to have, like, lessons in VCE, in Year 12, understanding...
Tourism.
Yeah, like, how to be Australians overseas, you know?
Yeah.
For tourism.
I mean, you are a big traveller, mate. Not that you're in KL in that story. Oh, we were hanging out at Adelaide Fringe recently, which was very... yes, exactly.
Exotic.
You must be tired. No. You were there for ages, like, doing shows. Does this mean you missed the whole Taylor Swift mayhem?
She completely screwed up one night of my life. And about...
Oh, really?
And everybody at the airport that night, the flights were just chaotic.
Okay.
My flights, I had three flights booked because they were backup flights because everybody was expecting a bit of drama because of Taylor Swift. I ended up getting to my show an hour late. The audience waited. But on the way there...
Well, you were an hour late for your own show.
And I had to tell everybody on Instagram. I was like, hey, everybody, I'm an hour late to my show. Do you mind waiting? And I thought nobody would wait. Most people waited because my audience are ethnic and they don't like wasting money. So.
Also, they never turn up on time.
So they were like, oh, that's, you know.
They're on their own clock.
So... as I was leaving the airport, I had to overtake this guy who was also in a rush and kind of upset. Everybody was pissed off. The alligator's there, frowning. And as I was trying to overtake him, this guy just elbows me in the ribs. And he's like, what's the rush, mate? I said, I've got to go to a show. And this is out of character. I turned to him, I said, just piss off. And then I walked off. And then he said, what'd you say? And I said, piss off. Oh. And then I had to loop back around up the ramp. And as I saw him, he had his phone out. He's like, got you now. But by that time, I'd already said, piss off.
Yeah.
And so I just pretended I was on my phone. But I have no idea if it's going to appear in the Daily Mail. But that's my defence.
Well, whatever you do, don't tell anyone about it.
Yeah.
Keep that one to yourself.
But it's Taylor Swift is to blame for that.
Oh, yeah, right. I see the connection.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Mate, I got to ask, your new show, Totally Normal, it's a great title. Is that how you would describe yourself?
Yeah, I'm completely normal. I mean, now the show is just, you know, it's just a title. I'm talking about the usual comedy stuff, you know, being a dad, you know, mental health.
It's just a title. Yeah, I'm talking about the usual comedy stuff.
Palestine, you know, just funny topics.
Yeah.
Inherently hilarious.
Just typical. Yeah, I'm totally normal. Basically, it's an hour of me just describing how, you know, much of a suitable, you know, I could be a parent. Please don't take my kids away.
Is there a danger?
No, there isn't.
I have to ask you this, though. So Ramadan starts next week.
Yeah.
And you keep making this ridiculous mistake of forgetting that Ramadan's happening and then booking all your shows on stage at the sunset when you're meant to be eating.
No, but it's a Melbourne Comedy Festival.
Oh, I know that, but you don't have to book it at sunset, mate. Well, are you going to be eating on stage this year is what I'm asking.
I'm going to be eating on stage. It's probably more of a problem for the Muslims that come to the show, but the first half of the Comedy Festival is during Ramadan, so that's not Muslim-friendly. The second half of the show, Muslim-friendly. Mm. So if you like Muslims, come to the second
if you hate them.
If you hate them, yeah. Well, come to the second part as well, cos you can meet them and you can tell them to piss off.
And then you can film them and then threaten to put it
absolutely
in the Daily Mail.
In the Daily Mail.
Mate, I have to say, you are a bit of a jungle master on I'm a Celeb. I'm about to be heading in there with Julia, who I know you're mates with. Uh-huh. Have you got any tips? Yeah. Mate, what do you reckon?
Firstly, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
I mean, when I heard Dr. Chris Brown was, you know, leaving, I was like, how can they replace him? And then I saw it was you, and I was like, oh, why did they even hire him in the first place? Like, of course, you're a better version. But Dr. Chris who? But any tips? Well, to be honest, I had no idea. Like, make yourself, like, lose your sense of smell. Get COVID, because all of us stink. There's no soap, no shampoo.
Got it.
Yeah. Under advisement.
Should be easy.
And now Naz is taking his new show across the country over the coming months. All the info's on our website. Would you please say, Nazeem,